coach you up and get you ready these last couple of years? And what would make him a pretty good defensive coordinator if he ascends that way?
Oh, definitely. I mean, just having a guy like me that's played the game for 10 years and has done it at a high level, I mean, it's a blessing and a curse, I say, because, you know, he knows everything that's going on the field. You know what I mean? He knows it like the back of his hand. I mean, he's basically, you know, him and Salah is definitely, you know, our leaders of the defense. But, you know, just by him being in and have played in that defense before, he knows what to expect. He's one of them guys that can break it down to where you understand it. And he does a good job of just, you know, explaining exactly, you know, what he wants out of you. And, I mean, he's a player's coach, too. Like, I mean, everybody loves D'Amico just because, you know, he's going to coach you. He's going to coach you hard. And sometimes you ain't going to like it. But at the same time, he's going to motivate you and tell you good job whenever you're doing something good. So, I mean, to have a coach that can give you the good and the bad and, you know, just have your back whatever, do whatever. I mean, that makes him a perfect D coordinator, I feel like.
Robert Saleh was just in here saying that you have a chance to be a really special player and that you haven't really even scratched the surface as to where you'll be in the next 3 to 4 years. How does that sort of feedback motivate you?
I mean, it motivates me a lot, you know. Every day I'm working, I'm working to, you know, get better for myself, you know, every day, you know, the little things, and that's what it's about. It's about the details, and, you know, I feel more confident every game as I, you know, continue to just understand things better, continue to see things, and just know the defense in and out, and, you know, to, you know, for, you know, coach to, you know, say something like that, and, you know, after how many guys he's coached, I mean, it just makes me want to work hard and makes me want to just, you know, get even better and be, you know, where I know I'm capable of being.
Robert Saleh was just in there and he said that Fred Warner is by far the best middle linebacker that's in football right now. He's starting to get a lot of accolades. What have you seen from him this year? And then also, one-on-one, what has he done for you in your development?
You know, just from Fred, all I've seen was him just be a leader, a captain, you know, just a guy that we can depend on every game. You know, Fred's going to give it his all. He's going to know the plays, you know. He's going to make all the checks, and he's somebody that you can always just count on no matter what. So, you know, to have a guy like that beside me to play with, you know, I'm just learning as much as I can from Fred just because he's that same guy every day, and that's why I'm striving to be, and you know, out there, I believe he's the best middle, you know, linebacker in ball, you know, just for the fact that, and you know, obviously you got Bobby and you know some other guys that are really good, but you know, just you know the plays that he make and the way that he do it, game in and game out, and you know, just the leadership and everything that he do. You know, on and off the field. I mean, it just makes him, you know, not only a great football player, but a great guy as well. So, I mean, he's just, you know, for me, he's done a great job of just, you know, he's basically a D coordinator right beside me. You know, he's smart. He's a smart guy. And, you know, when kind of fuzzy on some things, you know, whether it's where we're going in for that day or, you know, after practice and I'm trying to get a better understanding of, you know, maybe D'Amico, he just didn't give it to me right, Fred. He's gonna know it. He's knowing what I'm doing and what he's doing. So to have a guy like that, I mean, it's pretty cool.
Chris, I also said that your speed and range is up there with anyone. And you were just talking about the details. I imagine Salah would just like to see more consistency, you know, with every rep. What do you think it'll take for you to reach that ceiling that you're capable of? And as much as we talk about Fred, I want to know, how did Quan Alexander help you though?
Oh, I mean, for me, in order to reach that, you know, just it's about digging down deep inside, man. It's like the coach say, your why. You know why your why. Make sure your why is greater than, you know, than anything you face today. And, you know, things, you know, for me, I feel like I said about the details, but it's about, you know, formation recognition before. You know, before the snap, you know, I think Fred just does a good job of, you know, he he sees something and he kind of knows what to expect a little bit. And, you know, me just kind of, you know, playing off instincts a little bit. But, I mean, but just, you know, making sure I just, you know, just dig deep whenever, you know, things are going fast, making sure that, you know, I'm where I'm supposed to be, or, when you get tired of running down the field, you know, the next play, can you go down there and you do it again? And, you know, that's the things like that is what it takes to, you know, in order for, you know, to be, you know, like all pro Freddy and stuff like that. But, you know, my man Quan, you know, it was tough losing him. Definitely, you know, it hurt really, really bad, especially when it happened. And just knowing him for the time that I did, man, just a real dude. Like, that's all I can say, really, just a real dude going to come in. He's going to work, and he's going to have that same juice and that same energy every day. And, you know, when he's slacking, he wants you to tell him, like, hey, I'm slacking, and he's going to pick it right on up. So, you know, just that confidence too, man, just having someone like that in the room, you know, the confidence that he brought to, you know, everybody in the room, just, you know, it made you want to, you know, match that energy, match that confidence, and he did a great job. And, you know, that's just something I learned from him, just, you know, being that same guy and bringing that level, that energy, and it can, you know, I just saw how it just spread it out through the team. And, you know, for you know it, everybody in the team was, you know, flexing and, you know, yelling hot boys and everything like that. So it was a real honor to play with somebody, you know, like Quan Alexander.
Last one for Dre.
Dre, kind of a broad question, but what do you think the reasoning was behind the defense being so much sharper in the Washington game than the week earlier against Buffalo?
I feel like, you know, we definitely was, you know, on our details, on our assignment, and I think everybody played hard the Buffalo game just as hard as they played the Washington game. I think it was just, you know, sometimes when you get hit in the mouth, you got to just check yourself. You got to just, you know, ask, what are you doing wrong? And, you know, try to fix that as, you know, to the best of your ability. You can't look around nobody else. You got to look at yourself. And I think, you know, everybody just said, hey, you know, I made a mistake right here. I did this. I messed up. And, you know, not only do you not, you know, as an NFL player, you don't let the same thing happen twice, but you just, you know, you continue to get better off of it. You know, maybe it was something that you didn't understand about that coverage or whatever it was that may have, you know, you messed up on, but now, you know, when you see this, or, you know, now you know the details of that coverage. So this is, you know, what I'm supposed to do. And I think everybody was just so more focused on their job, their detail, and what they're supposed to do. And, you know, I think defensively we played a real good game.
Thank you, Dre.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Appreciate it, Chief.
Thank you, sir. Nice job.
Yes, sir. Thank you, my man. See you. There's a clue somewhere.
Yep, right there.